Now it is the time for the oath taking. Members to take oath or affirmation. Secretary General, please.
Kumar, who is selected from the constituency of Vijayawada, Andhra Pradesh, will now take the oath of affirmation. Mr. Aparanj Kumar, sir, do you want to take the oath or affirmation?
Oath, please. Hindi, please. Aparanj Kumar, jo yuva sansad ki sadasya nirvachit hoon. मैं ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूँ, सत्यनिष्ठ से प्रतिज्ञा करता हूँ कि विधि द्वारा स्थापित भारत के संविधान के प्रति श्रद्धा रखूंगा, देश की प्रभुसत्ता और एकता बनाए रखूंगा, तथा जिस पद को मैं ग्रहण करने वाला हूँ उसके कर्तव्य का श्रद्धा पूर्वक निर्वहन करूंगा।
मिस्टर आल प्रशांत, हु इज सेलेक्टेड फ्रॉम द तंजावूर कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी ऑफ तमिलनाडु will now take the oath or affirmation.
Alla Prashant, having been elected a member of the lower house of the youth parliament, solemnly affirm that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the constitution of India as by law established, that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India, and that I will faithfully discharge the duty upon which I am about to enter.
Mr. Srinath.
Srinath ane nenu యువ పార్లమెంట్ సభ్యునిగా ఎన్నికైన తరువాత భారత రాజ్యాంగం పట్ల నిజమైన విశ్వాసం మరియు విధేయతను చూపిస్తానని ధృవీకరిస్తున్నాను. చట్టం ప్రకారం నేను భారతదేశం యొక్క సార్వభౌమత్వాన్ని మరియు సమగ్రతను కాపాడుతానని, నా విధిని లేక కర్తవ్యాన్ని నిష్పక్షపాత రహితంగా నిర్వహిస్తానని దైవసాక్షిగా ప్రమాణం చేస్తున్నాను.
Pranab Mukherjee led some of the nation's most powerful ministries and eventually became its president, but the ultimate prize still eluded him, the prime ministership. Valued for his ability to bring consensus by exerting his charm to bring together the disparate groups, Mukherjee never won the top job despite decades of loyalty to the Congress party. The former college teacher, journalist, lacked a grassroots political base, but held more than a dozen federal portfolios between 1973 and 2012, ranging from finance to defense and external affairs. So, raised hackles as when finance minister in 2012, he demanded $2 billion from Vodafone, India's largest overseas corporate investor, as part of retrospective tax on long-concluded corporate deals. Mukherjee entered parliament in 1969, following his father into the Congress party led by Indira Gandhi, just as she steered the country on a sharp turn towards socialism. He rose under Gandhi's mentorship, only to be sidelined by his son, Rajiv Gandhi, in elections of 1984. But Mukherjee managed to regain his proximity to the Congress leadership and Gandhi's family, becoming one of the India's most influential politicians during 1990s and 2000s by building deep network in inter-party relationships. He played a tremendous role in policies right from 1980s. His services are irreplaceable.
With the coronavirus crisis restricting not just foreign tourist footfalls into the country, but also keeping the domestic tourists at bay, the budget has focused on pushing funds for promotion and publicity to help the Woo tourists back. Out of the ₹668.72 crores allocated towards promotion and publicity, ₹524.02 crores is for overseas market and ₹144.70 crores has been kept for domestic tourists. With the coronavirus crisis bringing the tourism sector to its knees, the union budget has allocated a sum of ₹63.65 crores for capacity building for service providers and ₹138.65 crores for training and skill development.
India's power consumption grew at 3-month high rate of 10.2 at 111.43 billion units in January 2021, showing spurt in economic activities according to official data. Power consumption in January 2020 was 101.15 billion units. Besides, peak power demand also recorded a double-digit growth of nearly 11%. At 189.43 GW in January 2021 compared to 170.97 GW in January 2020. The 189.64 GW peak power demand recorded on January 30 was also all-time high so far. Thank you.
Terrorists and insurgents in India have become the gravest threat to our country. The extent and magnitude of their operations is so gigantic that they are affecting the social, economical and political and as well as the well-being of our country. There are sources of insurgents and terrorist groups operating in the country. They are Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jai-e-Mohammed, Harakat-ul-Mujahideen, the Communist Party of India, Harakat-ul-Jihad-i-Islami, the United Liberation Front of Assam, and other groups became the biggest challenge to our national security. They have complete disregard for democracy, law, and human values. They have been committing crimes like abduction and killing with impunity. There is an urgent need to counter the terrorism and insurgency in our country. Thank you.
Throw a light on religious equality. Religious equality means treating all the religions the same. Christians, Sikhs, Muslims, and Jews, Buddhists, and as well as all denominations with each other. Religious coexistence is the idea that people of different religions can live together in peace and harmony without any conflicts. Freedom of religion in India is a fundamental right guaranteed by Article 25 to 28 of Constitution of India. Modern India came into existence in 1947 and Indian Constitution preamble was amended in 1976 to state that India is a secular state. Father of Nation, who is Mahatma Gandhi, said that religions are different roads converging to the same point. That does not matter that we can take different roads so long as we can reach the same goal. In reality, these are as many religions as there are individuals. These words are said by Father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi. But Honorable Speaker Madam, my question is, in these days also there are so many accidents and attacks are taking place about Christianity by killing some Christians and firing some Bibles and also firing churches and campaigning against Christians. We are seeing these accidents and incidents day by day. News about firing of churches is also a big issue nowadays. Honorable Speaker Madam, I would like to know what is government taking the steps and what is the corresponding minister taking steps about these issues. Thank you, Madam, for giving me this golden opportunity.